what would typically happen is one of two things. Kids, I would go home at night, I'd sit down, I'd look at my email, and I'd have these emails from my kids saying, Mr. Dahlman, I remember you talking about how to explain evidence in an argumentative essay, but I don't remember. Can you tell me about that again? And I'd have to write out a long email, or I'd have to say, that's too hard to do over email, talk to me in the morning. So I either had to go that way, or the other option was students would typically just not do their homework and then come in the next day and say, like, I didn't understand, so I had nothing to do. So I was really hitting that roadblock of complex learning task. I forgot how to do it properly. I quit, or I'm going to ask you to do it over email instead of in a more personal manner. So. Okay, so the impact of these instructional videos have been pretty large. I get students that feel more empowered to take control of what they have to do, their troubleshooting and problem-solving skills. They have an avenue to follow instead of just feeling hopeless. For me, I feel confident knowing that I have something that I put out there that allows my students, when they feel like they don't remember how to do it, because some of these complex tasks, I'm asking kids to learn about it in the morning, go through an entire school day, and then go home and then try to take that on. I feel more confident knowing that they have the resources available to be successful. And for parents, it's twofold. One, they know where to direct their kids to get the help that their students need, which is, as a parent myself, is sometimes a powerless feeling. This gives them that option and they know where to go. And two, the parents can watch my instruction. And then when they're working with the kid, they can reinforce the things I'm asking them to do or better understand the steps that I'm asking the students to take. So it's been very helpful on a number of different levels for that. The first thing I would say if you were going to make your own instructional videos would be first to have very concise and clear learning targets and one learning target per video. The more you can break it down, the more effective it's going to be for kids, because if I'm putting three learning targets inside of one video, and the kid maybe only needs one or doesn't understand how they all go together, they may get confused or they may find it difficult to find exactly what it is that they're looking for. So if I'm like, my perfect example would be when I'm teaching kids how to write an argumentative essay and I'm asking them to explain their evidence, I give them like three steps. I will do a video for step one, a video for step two, and then a video for step three. That way then if they're hung up on one of the steps, they only need to watch that one, or they can watch it sequentially and follow the steps that I'm asking them to follow, and it makes it more clear for them. So having a clear and concise idea of what exactly the learning target is or skill I want to have in there, and then also making it short and to the point, because kids, when I go on the longer videos, don't have that idea of like, I'm gonna sit here and watch a 5-minute video about how to analyze a political cartoon. They want that information and they're able to absorb it better in about a minute to a minute and a half. And so the shorter and more concise you are, better to, and also the last thing is to replicate as closely as you can what you're doing in the classroom. So if it's short, focused, and replicated with an experience they already have, they then have the mindset that allows them to absorb that material better.